Guess where I'm at? Come on. Think about it. If the Earth's back there, I must be on the moon. And why coming to you live from the moon waiting for silver to arrive? This just in, breaking news. Silver squeeze? When? When? Because some of my audience has ADHD. May 1st, my friends. I'm up here trying to support you silver guys, you silver stackers, right? We're here to be our own central bank. Stacking silver, gold. Actually, being your own bank would mean making loans that you don't even have money for. Actually, I'd love to be a bank. I sit here, hold on. And write a check just for you. Check. $1 million. Give it to whoever, and voila, I just created $1 million. That's actually what the banks do. They don't even need reserves, nothing. They're just, hey, look, we have $1 million on our balance sheet now. And I'd say that's some trickery. I'm going to have to tell someone about it. What are they going to do about it? Yeah, never mind. I mean, imagine the day that people actually find out where money comes from, what the Fed really is. I mean, even the Fed lies about it. They're on, you know, whatever, CNN, CNBC, ABC, DEFG, and they're like, so do you make money? And they're like, yes, essentially we create money out of thin air and we go burr. And I personally think you guys give the Fed way too much credit. It's like God mode, but here. And if you're like, oh, don't trust the Fed, it's a private bank, blah, blah, blah. Okay, right, yeah, you're right, but now you're going to trust this.
Simply flooded the system with money.
Yes, we did. That's another way to think about it. We did.
Where does it come from? Do you just print it?
We print it digitally. So we, you know, we as a central bank, we have the ability to create money digitally. And we do that by buying treasury bills or bonds or other government guaranteed securities. And that actually increases the money supply.
Okay. Just about everything you said is not true. Jerome, you create reserves. That's all you do, my friend. I know. Just tell everyone you just, you go burr. You'll fix the market. But what is true money? Well, this just in, breaking news. Is it silver? Is it gold? Is it Bitcoin? And these banks cannot print. Well, almost got me on that one there. They cannot print Bitcoin unless it's a derivative. You cannot print gold unless it's a derivative. And for our silver stackers, unless it's heavy and you can put it in your pocket, you ain't got silver. And as you know, I will do my best to support your causes of money, real money. So off I go to Reddit. And here you go. Here you go, Tim. Here's your shout out. May 1st, May Day, May Day is going to be massacre for the COMEX. And then there's words that I cannot read on the YouTubes. Otherwise, they go, no, you said it. Oh man, if you guys even knew behind the scenes, and then, because I'll read stories and I'm like, ooh, can't say that. So over the next 10 days, we will prepare your silver. And if they can get 100,000 people, let me see if I can zoom in, like you guys taught me, to buy 100 ounces. Ooh, that's kind of a lot of ounces, just saying. It's kind of a thick bar. So, if you guys have roughly $3,000, holding like a silver bar just has a better feel than holding where's my Bitcoin? I don't see it. But you guys want to know what kind of stoof I really like to hold? I know, it's been a while, right? This is the first stoof on the moon. Actually, here, I will do an unboxing. Let's do an unboxing video. You want to see? I think you guys are going to be pleasantly disappointed with this stoof. I'm just saying. Let me open this. This is going to end up getting all over my... You hear that? Mm. Oh, we peel it back. Let's see. Here we go. These things are very expensive, by the way. Oh, man. Here it is, the unboxing. You guys ready for the unboxing? Do you see that? Oh my goodness. For all of you that are low carbon, I mean, that's not bad, right? Yeah, that doesn't really match up. So this is the first stoof on the moon. I'm not saying that this this probably doesn't look so much like that, right? Maybe false advertising. It's all you guys need is 100,000 people spending around $3,000. Okay, all right. And my derivatives, my SLV, my paper traders, my PSLV, you guys can get in there too. Maybe buy some. Oh, not financial advice. You might lose all your money, which we'll hit the charts in just a moment to see how much money you could possibly lose. Or what I'm thinking is you could, as an options trader, right? Just take delivery, but then they could just pay you in cash and kind of defeats the purpose, right? And the banks just get us every single time. You know, the board games, the monopolies all set up. You're like, I own Park Place, I own Boardwalk. I'm taking this down. And then all of a sudden the banks, right, start printing money. Well, monopoly money. And then they call it reserves and everyone freaks out and says, look at all this money that's being printed, and freaks out, and there goes the market. And coming in from more fundamentals, the fundamental side rather than the technical, this is kind of technical down there. Yeah, it's fundamentals. I'll get into the technicals in just a moment. COMEX register bleeds another lot of digits. 1,100,000 PSLV, up another 600,000 ounces. PSLV. What? Just say silver. Surplus. Oh, so here we go. Here is your COMEX registered inventory and our short squeeze approaching and our deficit and the surplus. We will see. Just keep draining, because there's really, I mean, the amount of silver in the world is so tiny, but yet so controlled by central banks that will just, because they could just hit digits on the screen, right? And we will just go ahead and short a trillion. Oh, hey, look, everyone's running. Well, everyone's running for silver because they know it's real and it's not fake belief. A global silver demand poised to what? Rise this year. Not financially, this is Market Watch. Prices could jump more than 30%. I would love 30% more stoof. You cannot get enough stoof. But now we have to look at the technicals. And for those of you that are like, what are all those lines? Well, I didn't draw them. They click a couple buttons and you're like, oh, so this is what happens when this line crosses with that line. That would be called a golden cross. And when those said lines cross the other way. So here we go. There was our golden cross. And what happens to the price? Do you like that? Ah, so beautiful. So beautiful. Now, see the 50 and the 200? You know, see this? The green and red one? The red one's the 50. The green one is the 200. Now, if they violently cross, when the 50 violently crosses over the 200, that is a death cross. Now, I have to say, I do not see a strong trend. I mean, the banks would really have to come in and just smash this thing like no other. And silver's been really holding this 26, 27 level very, very strong. Also known as a tight bandwidth. Some of you men, you like tight bandwidth. You're at the bar and you're like, you got a tight bandwidth? Well, I don't know what that is, but I got a tight hotspot. Actually, my internet gets so bad over here. I actually have to turn on my own hotspot on my phone. I'm like, shoot, my phone's faster than my dang house. Well, except when I'm plugged into the blue wire, right? Then it's very fast. But we in our houses don't like plugging things in with wires. I mean, honestly, my Mbps is like 15 throughout the house. And yes, I have all the gadgets turned on. Everyone's turned on in my house. So let's do a deep dive into technicals. What do I use? I use TradingView. And if this, you're like, wait, what's TradingView? I just use Robinhood. I have a course that I constantly add to. And then I think I'm going to have like a very advanced section in it. I think it's from basic to middle. Like, okay, you got the swing trade, you got that. I think if you got 80%, you're pretty good in these markets. Let me head on over to futures and let me click on silver just for you as I'm filming this. We're currently down 0.5%. But that is not as much of a percent as I give off my course. Oh, do you see that plug? I was like, hey, this is a good time. 70%-ish today on being able to click on these things that I also teach in college and high school, right?
Here we go. Oh,
and also, if you guys are super, I love this stuff. I don't know what it is. I turn on this chart. It turns, well, I turn on the chart. Right away, my brain goes, this. When I used to work law enforcement, there were certain things that I'm like, this. You're like, you did? Anyways, I was also in the military. Yes, I was. I've done, you name it, I've probably done it. If you name it, I've probably done it. I have no joke for that. But let's do some TA for you. Hold your horses. I should just do these things. Let's see. See how well I can draw that. Right about there. Hold on. Let me come down a little. It's actually really important. I don't want you guys to lose any money off of this. Yep. Yeah. Shoot. Missed it by a tad. Do you see this? When it finds support off of that? Oh. Are we going to the moon? How do you like my wedgie? You see that? There we go. Also, if you guys really want to get into this, go down here to the bottom right. Click on trading panel. Click on paper trading and then click connect. Because that's all we do on this channel. Just paper trade so you don't lose any of your money. But you'll still feel the same thing. You're like, yeah, I'm up. And then people are like, but for real money? You're like, well, I'm up. I tell people that are in my course, I need you paper trading for like at least a month. What do you guys think? 2 months? 3 months? If it's crypto, maybe 3 years. Also, one more thing before I forget. I never want to see you do this. Oh, Bravo's daily watch list. $19 a month. Hey. Okay, well, if he's doing it, I guess I'll do it. That is a no. No, you need to learn first. And then, which I had to do this probably, I don't know, 4 months ago. I don't know how long I've been. And this is not passive income, by the way. Not the things that I like doing, spending hours and hours and hours on trade setups. And I definitely don't want to waste your time by just sitting there turning like, okay, we're going to go live. Here I am. That'd be so boring. Oh my gosh. It'd be like watching grass grow. I'm like, okay, so let's see here. We're cooling off. I mean, let me just tell you, on silver, I don't like our direction of the RSI. I mean, I like where it's at. I just don't like the direction. I think you guys, how I enter, let me show you. If I was trading on the daily, that's that one. That, see this right here? That's your Heikinashis. Heikinashis, I turn those on. Now you have to know when to use them and when to not use them. Just because it's big, strong green, it doesn't mean like, come on in. And hopefully in my course, I have enough indicators that you're like, okay. That's where it's like kind of that beginner. If you can't see things, I don't know where I just went. Popped on over to American Airlines. I guess I should be trading that right now. My computer's like, wait, hold on. Take a look. What's happening here? On the buy indicator, gives you another, right? Buy. Okay. Doesn't mean buy. It means you got to do your own due diligence. I also do not like me being in the way of something. Let's show you on the MACD. See? Uh-oh. I don't like what I'm seeing here. This is a strong buy down here. Oh, actually, I need to turn on an arrow so you can see where I'm saying. See? There's your buy. We're cooling off. And then you see these, the lines diverge. Let's say they diverge in the wrong direction, even though I do want to support you guys. But then I would look at the charts and I'm like, oh, I just don't want to see anyone lose money. And that's why I add up all the probabilities. You know, maybe let's say there's 10 of them. You're like, okay, well, I got 9 out of 10. And pull the trigger. And also, if you think that all trades go my way, oh my gosh, they don't. I mean, even when I've been, I have done very well in crypto, just the luck of the draw, right? On Bitcoin, I really, really wanted to catch this one. Well, without catching falling knives, on the daily, it's telling you no, no, no. But I'm like, let's trade this one on the hour. And I'll tell you why. That line right there, I'm like, come on, bounce off of it. Let's go to the moon. And here was a trade that I recently took. Wish I wouldn't have. Right? So, buy indicator comes on, gets the beat down. Our Heikinashi's like, yes, puts in a buy. And then look at this. Look at that. Just took me out. And I thought I was just going to bust right through that hole and off to the moon. Didn't happen. And that's why it's so important to have like, thanks. Having these perfect setups. Well, as perfect as you can get. So, and I want to support my silver stackers. There we go. I'm here. I am here waiting on the moon. I see Bitcoin. Doge was here a minute ago. But thank you guys for making it to the very end. And I will see you tomorrow.